This week on Machinery Pete TV, the winning combination of good condition and low hours proves its value again on this Sidney, Iowa sale with a beautiful Case IH 275 Magnum. A wide front Minneapolis Moline shows off its top to bottom restoration. And this Horsch air seater offers a simpler planning solution in both Europe and North America.
Your machinery is a serious investment and at the heart of every farming operation. Some call it a passion. We're Machinery Pete TV, and today we'll cover everything from auction roundups to the classics to the latest trends and technology. Machinery Pete, the most trusted name in farm equipment.
Machinery Pete thanks these premier sponsors for their support. For farmers working to lift, change, and repair tires, check out the Tire Grabber at thetiregrabber.com. No other cornhead works like a Drago, or pays you back like one. Visit your Drago dealer and see how you can justify owning a Drago on ROI alone.
Hey folks, welcome to Machinery Pete TV, coming at you from sunny Sidney, Iowa today. Now the air temp is a crispy 9 below, but you know, the key when it's below zero is the wind, and the wind is down today, so it's actually not too bad. Ice cold, but I think we're gonna see some red hot bidding on three Case IH tractors. So stay tuned for that.
But first, we gotta go back to the studio and get the latest farm equipment news.
I'm Clinton Griffiths with an update on the industry. Case IH going big this week with the release of its new AF11 combine. Case IH showing off the new 775 horsepower machine that includes a first ever dual rotor, 567 bushel grain tank, and a 6 bushel per second unload rate. It also boasts improved fuel efficiency and longer run times. Technology wise, the combine marches steadily toward full automation. You can see the AF11 in person this month at the National Farm Machinery Show. Farmer sentiment continues to trend lower according to the latest Ag Economy Barometer from Purdue University and the CME Group. The January index falling 8 points to 106 as producers continue to sour on the outlook of their farm's current situation. Surveyors say anticipated lower farm income in 2024 is driving the increased negativity. More producers also saying now is a bad time to make large investments due to uncertainty in profitability. And 2024 could be a record year for restaurants. The National Restaurant Association reporting the food service industry could see $1.1 trillion in sales for the first time in history. However, just over 25% of restaurant operators say their establishments will be more profitable this year, with many blaming higher food and labor costs. Now, let's check on some auctions from around the country. Now back to our host, Machinery Pete.
Hey folks, it's 9 below zero here today, so don't you dare change that dial. And you're not gonna wanna miss the red hot bidding coming up on this baby, a 21 model Case IH Maxim 150. This thing's only got 140 hours on it.
Today, when you're looking for a way to harvest more corn, you can count on Drago to get the job done. With self-adjusting deck plates, more aggressive gathering chains, and longer knife rollers for less ear bounce, Drago corn heads make every hybrid yield better. You'll like their durability too. No other corn head works like a Drago, or pays you back like one. Visit your Drago dealer and see how you can justify owning a Drago on ROI alone.
Well, good morning. Welcome back to the channel. So we're gonna be taking off these 800 metric Goodyear LSWs and putting on 320s, narrow ones. Man, that tire grabber system is incredible. I think it took us less than 45 minutes to change them for the first time. I guarantee you it's gonna be quicker than that next time.
Hey folks, Machine Repeat here. You've got to try this. The power of foam is the only way to clean and degrease your equipment. Simply foam it on, give the foam a few minutes to work, and power wash it off. Cuts grease and your wash time significantly. The foam won't harm electrical sensors or controls. It neutralizes and washes away farm chemicals and is safe to use on most surfaces. Call 888-996-7801 or go online to check out their dealer locator at powerofoam.com to find the power of foam near you. Hey folks, a real treat. I'm here with my friend Tom Schramm with Schramm Auction Incorporated. Tom, always great to see you.
Yeah, great to see you, Greg. Yeah. Appreciate it.
Now this sale in particular, wow, quite a line of equipment here, Tom. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, probably one of the pieces of equipment with the most interest is right behind us is a 2010 Magnum 275 with 1,800 hours pre-def tractor of very sought after tractor.
Now, Tom, I know you sell green, red, blue, but it's got to be kind of fun to get this quality of equipment on a sale, I would imagine.
Yeah, you know, the good low-houred one-owner equipment always sells good, and off of a farm retirement sale, I think it helps, you know, and people can come and see where it's coming from and meet the seller, and I think that adds a lot of merit to the sale.
All right, folks, beautiful tractor here, a 2013 Case IH Magnum 235, only 1,374 hours on it. Now, the 10 highest auction prices ever on Magnum 235s, all in the last 21 months since April of 22. But now the calendar's flipped, we've lost the year-end tax buyers, corn and beans down in price a little bit before the auction. Time to see what this baby goes for. Well, folks, the average auction price last year in 2023 on a Case IH Maxim 150 was $78,779. Now, today here in Sidney, Iowa on the Lawrence Crumb Retirement Auction, this is not any average Maxim 150. This is a 21 model with only 140 hours on it. And last night, the online bidding was already up over $91,000. That's already the fourth highest one I've ever seen.
34. Click the button, boys. 134. 133. Turn them below number 4. 4 upon 34. I'm at 134. Do you get 4 now? Below number 4. 4 upon 35. I'm at 133. 4 now. Below number 4. 4 upon 34. 134,000. Flip your way. 133,000. Tim gets them your way. Buyer number is? 297.
Here are a few more items that sold on today's sale. Best way I've seen to fix faded paint? Dakota Shine. Made in South Dakota by Dakota Ag Innovations, a company with a 20-year history of working with top construction equipment manufacturers, now offering Dakota Shine to the farm community to help you keep your equipment looking like new and retain more value when it comes time to sell or trade. Key active ingredient from corn soy derivatives. Order online at dakotashine.com or visit your regional farm stores to pick up your Dakota Shine today.
Our 27th annual winter equipment auction is Thursday, February the 15th. For details, go to bidschmidt.com. It is an online-only auction with no buyer premium. We have tractors, combines, semis, dump trucks, grain trucks, hopper bottoms, dump trailers, planters, tillage equipment, hay equipment, and much more. Ring 1 starts to close at 9 a.m. on the 15th. The auction is located 4 miles east of Effingham, Illinois. bidschmidt.com.
What's that piece of equipment worth? Check out Machinery Pete's auction prices for the answer. Free to view, updated daily, all types of equipment. Go to machinerypete.com and click on the auction tab, then auction price data.
Well, good morning. Welcome back to the channel. So we're going to be taking off these 800 metric Goodyear LSWs and putting on 320s, narrow ones. Man, that tire grabber system is incredible. I think it took us less than 45 minutes to change them for the first time. I guarantee you it's going to be quicker than that next time.
Oh yeah, that's beauty. So when we would push it in like that with our blue jack would go, and then come back, and then come back. No moving.
Good morning. Today we are changing spare tires inside of the shed.
3 points of contact, lift it up. Go. Now it's already ready to go on the sprayer.
Okay, tire time.
Welcome back to Tractor Tales, folks. This week, we're going to venture to Central Michigan to learn about a restored 1950 Moline.
We've got a 1950 Minneapolis Moline RTE. The RTE meant that it had an extendable wide front. The Moline R was the smallest tractor Minneapolis Moline made until they bought the BF Avery Company in '52. It's about 25 horsepower. It's got 165 cubic inch engine, four-speed transmission. The extendable wide front, they made 1,115 versions with the extendable wide front, so it's fairly rare. We bought it over in Central Michigan, 98, I think. We restored this tractor in 2002. The previous owner we bought it from, it had a bad engine knock, so we ended up putting new rings, bearings, all the new gaskets in the motor, put it right back together like it was, everything was great. Gone through the tractor front to rear, all new seals, bearings were needed, brakes, so on, clutch. The engine design was unique that Minneapolis Moline advertised that you could service it from a milk stool. So you could sit on a milk stool and on the left side of it, you can take the whole side of the engine off as one cover and get to your crankshaft and your rods and replace bearings and adjust bearings if need be. But yeah, that was, they claimed it had a 140 or less parts than a typical four-cylinder engine in a tractor of its day. So they were really touting how less parts it had and how more efficient it was. This was only available in gas. There was possibly one or more prototype propane versions, but they were never in mass production. It took us 4 years to restore this one. It's the first tractor we ever restored back in 2002. And so it took us, we got it in, I think, 98, and it took us till 02 to restore it. The barn's mostly full of Molines.
Hey folks, it's 9 below outside, but I am toasty warm here in the cab of this 2010 Magnum 275, our feature item on the auction today. Stick around, this baby's only got 1,796 hours on it.
Today, when you're looking for a way to harvest more corn, you can count on Drago to get the job done. With self-adjusting deck plates, more aggressive gathering chains, and longer knife rollers for less ear bounce, Drago corn heads make every hybrid yield better. You'll like their durability too. No other corn head works like a Drago, or pays you back like one. Visit your Drago dealer and see how you can justify owning a Drago on ROI alone.
The only way I've seen to safely clean aluminum grain on stock trailers is Bright Plus Aluminum Cleaner from Dakota Ag Innovations. With over 15 years of proven performance cleaning all types of aluminum, the results speak for themselves. Dirty, stained, and discolored aluminum trailers don't stand a chance against Bright Plus Aluminum Cleaner. Safely improve the appearance of your aluminum trailers at home and make a statement with Bright Plus. Order today at trailercleaner.com or find Bright Plus Aluminum Cleaner at a farm store near you.
Got equipment to sell privately but tired of scams and hassles? Visit machinerypete.com and click Sell Mine. Machinerypete.com, the simple and secure way to buy and sell equipment online.
Pre-def, good condition, low hours. Folks, that has been the winning poker hand the last couple years here. And I tell you, our feature item on the auction today, beautiful 2010 Case IH Magnum 275, one owner, only 1,796 hours. Now the three highest auction prices I've ever seen on Magnum 275s all came in 2023.
I got 140 in the bank,
163, now 164, 160 more, 164, no more, no more, no more, now 5. 165, bottom of my player, 165, 165 pounds there, 166 pounds, bottom of my player, 166.
Hey folks, let's hop in that Machine Repeat time machine and go back to February of 2013. In Warrensburg, Illinois, we saw Magnum 275 with only 371 hours, so for 152.5. That record stood for about 10 years, but things are different now. We just saw it on our feature item, the Magnum 275 here. 1,796 hours, comes in 165, third highest price ever.
Learning and using new technologies can be complicated, but sometimes technologies simplify the process. That's certainly the case with the Horsch Maestro Seeder and its innovative seed delivery system.
Showing here today is one of our Maestro CX planters. Now, this particular planter that you see here is built more for the Western European market, but when we build our Maestro planters for the North American market, we're using the same row units, we're using the same metering technology, same electronic system, so a lot of shared components between these machines. The platforms may change, but the heart of the machine remains the same. This has a very similar setup to what we have on a new product line that we just launched in the US called Maestro SX. And both the CX and the SX utilize a new metering system that we've launched here called the Airspeed system, using a positive pressure metering system for high-speed planting. So today when we take a look at high-speed planters, there's been always some type of a mechanical device that brings the seed from the disc down to the furrow. What we've done is really simplified the whole process by, number one, taking away the vacuum. We're only using one fan to both deliver the seed from the bulk hopper and also to pressurize the meter and also to shoot the seed down into the furrow. So taking a hydraulic circuit out, taking a lot of complexity out, and all of the power needed for this unit comes right off the tractor. No gen sets needed. So the way the system works is you have a simple seed disc here, and it's all about controlling the airflow. So whenever we have the seed delivery hose coming in that brings the seed into the seed cup here, we also pressurize this toolbar where we're wying off the airflow. Part of the airflow is coming here. You'll see the seed that'll come out here that pressurizes what we call this air chamber. And in that air chamber, that seed gets pushed onto the disc and then run through the singulator, making sure we got one seed per hole. On the back side of the meter, the other edge of the Y comes around and then necks down, which by necking it down, we increase the pressure. And then here we come down into an angled loop where we create more of a suction and a shooting pressure going down. So as that seed comes around on the disc, it's pulled off the disc and shot into the furrows.
Well folks, Sidney, Iowa today, really fun to be here for the Lawrence and Mary Lou Crom Farm Retirement Auction, and we proved again that adverse weather equals hot bidding, 9 below 0 today, but actually not too bad, it's not very windy, and fun to watch that Magnum 275 sell for the third highest price ever, and record price on the Maxim 150 of 133. We'll see you back here next week on Machine Repeat TV.
Machine Repeat thanks these premier sponsors for their support. For farmers working to lift, change, and repair tires, check out the Tire Grabber at thetiregrabber.com. No other cornhead works like a Drago or pays you back like one. Visit your Drago dealer and see how you can justify owning a Drago on ROI alone.